Hello YouTube, this is the Global Gamer here again with a brand new Let's Play, this time of Dragons Dogma, Dark Arisen. And yeah, this is a game that I've played very little of. It's a new game to PC. The PC port came out in January 2016, so just this year. I think it was about halfway through that month. And yeah, pretty much I've been in the game, I've optimized the settings, I've made everything look smooth and fancy, and everything looks nice, and I'm hoping with this setup at least that I can get 720p at 30 frames per second on the recording with the Dark Souls let's play our playthrough. We could not get that. We were getting the quality below 720, I think it was 360p, and we were getting 30 frames though, so we kind of had to switch it up a bit. So yeah, I've actually optimized it, so hopefully we can get 720p or just a little less, but that we also get 30 frames. So we started the game already. However, we're going to start a new game. That was when you just optimize the settings and have a look around. And I hope it saves them too. Proceed. And we're going to go for normal difficulty. It's actually the highest we can choose. You can select hard mode after you've already started the game and finished the tutorial area. But from what I've read, the difference between normal mode is pretty difficult. It's like the standard difficulty, and it's a little bit easier than Dark Souls, obviously, but it's not easy because the enemies don't take a lot of damage and you take a lot of damage. Easy mode halves the damage you take and doubles the damage you do, and hard mode does the opposite. It doubles the damage you'd normally take in normal mode and halves the damage you do. And from what I've seen, it just makes enemies complete sponges, and you pretty much die from one hit from basic enemies, and it's not very fun when you're getting one hit by any attack from a boss either. So that's why I arrived at normal mode. In this first episode, we're just going to be going through character creation, the tutorial area, if there is one. Well, there is. It's not a tutorial per se, but it's an area before you make your character. We're going to do this tutorial part, then we're going to do the character creation. And then we're just going to do the first starting area before episode 2. It's pretty dark. So pretty much the I key opens your inventory. Then you can bind things. Now, as far as I know, to bind things, you just need to put the number on them, the key that you want to bind them to, and it's a number pad thing. So I have one, I'm using an MMO mouse, so I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, all the way up to 12 buttons on the mouse to bind things to. So that's the torch, the lantern. So we've bound that to 1, and I'm just going to see if I can up the sensitivity a bit. So to escape this menu, you just press escape, but I assume I will do the same thing. Now for settings, it should be the settings that we had for the previous thing. I didn't change much anyways. Keyboard and mouse, camera sensitivity. I'm going to put this up a bit. I want it to be a bit more reactive. Save changes. The menus are awkward to use at first, but I've gotten kind of used to them. They're okay. And, yeah. So we're going to go back into options. I just wanted to save those changes. Audio, visual. Now we're going to put, okay, so connectivity is online. So we're going to save that. And pawn subtitles display, we're going to put that off. Pawn chatter is on, cutscene subtitles on. Okay, that's kind of how I like it. And hopefully we can have a look at visual. And hopefully we can put it up a bit. We want something to look smooth, but I'm not too much of a... Okay, so we've got good resolution, we full screen on, frame rate is 60, we'll leave it at 60, VSync is on, shadow qualities are low, things like this I keep on low, there's no need for them to be on high, distance scaling, I kind of wish that was higher, but we'll just stick with these standard settings. The game usually detects pretty well, and I've never had a trouble so far, so yeah. Now we're going to press the 1 key, and there we go. Now, this is a jump key. I kind of wish it was a bit more responsive. The controls feel clunky. The dragon's roost is just beyond. So E is your interact key, and enter, I don't know what it does, but E is the interact key, which is pretty cool. I'm used to the enter. I wonder, so shift is run. Is that a Dargon? Okay. This is our shield, I think. Nope. Left alt is blocked. Now that is awkward. So, left alt. I have no idea why I'm holding up the shield. I did not. There we go. So it seems to auto-adjust. Now, is there a lock-on key? I don't think there is. Now, for some reason, I'm holding up this shield. Oh, okay, I get it. It's just the controls are slightly unresponsive. Not super unresponsive. So, I wanted to see something. So, that's a swing. Oh, I get it. Okay, so I was clicking the left mouse button to use my left hand and the right mouse button to use my right hand. But I'm still suffering from Dark Souls controller sickness, which is an awful port, so I can't blame this game's controls on that. But yeah. To block. Okay, so left control is your power attacks, I guess, or your abilities, and alt is the shield stuff. Okay. So this is left alt. It offers you your shield abilities, but also holds up your shield. Now, I hate shields in every game, so I'll not be probably using this class. This is just a tutorial area again. Okay, these are goblins. Now, there's no lock-on, which is crazy. So let's have a look at these abilities. Blink Strike. Ah, so it auto-targets, I guess, the closest guy. Ah, and in the bottom corner we see our health and our stamina. Now stamina is pretty slow to regenerate, but let's just run. It gets consumed pretty slowly as well, so this is acceptable, I guess. It seems super, super unresponsive to the character though, but it's possibly just a kind of a being used to Dark Souls that I've kind of feel like he's moving slowly. Because the frames don't seem that bad. I guess it's just a slower paced game. So, as you can see, I'm not suffering from frames dropping when I run. But I do feel like when I'm walking, it's because the game is lagging. But clearly it's not. It's just kind of... it's just a different, slower paced game than I'm used to, I guess. I've been saying I guess a lot. No double jump. It's strange to be able to jump though. I'm not used to that. And it's also strange to have to manually target. She's in the sky and I've no like jumping abilities, I don't believe. So Skyward Lash, what's that do? Oh, it swings up, so I guess I can use that. Where is this lady? Well, she's not exactly a lady, but I can't find her. Ooh, that looks cool. I like the look of this place. I've been to this area already. This is a tutorial area, but I kind of ran through it just for checking performance and stuff. I didn't really go through the controls yet. I did get that shift as running, and that also puts away your weapon. I had a little look around the menu. I wonder if I can do a plunging attack. I can! I like this game already. At least I won't die from too much fall damage, eh? There's no rolling. Yeah. Now, what I'm trying to do is figure out a way to actually just like spam. I guess this is our spam key. L1. And even then, it's kind of like, When you hit something, it kind of slows down time for a second, like as if it's an impact of your hit. It's going to take a bit of getting used to, but I mean, At least as long as I know it's not a frame issue, I can deal with it. Because then you have to start optimizing things, and that gets messy. And I do barely any damage either to these goblins with the sword strike, which is not the same as Dark Souls, but I take a lot less damage. Like, I'm over half health, and I've got hit half a dozen times. That's pretty handy. This is another one, the Harpy Lady. So if I try Skyward Lash when we get close... Oh, it got her. Great. Oh, damn it. Spamming the A and D keys. I wonder, can you die from fall damage like that? That would be pretty cool. Oh, so he's holding. So yeah, these guys that are with us, they're called Pawns. Now, we can make our own Pawn, and my idea for our character is going to have a cool adventuring duo. You can have up to four, and you can summon other players' Pawns instead of using your own... Well, you can only have one of your own Pawns, but you can have a party of four, two being other players' Pawns or in-game NPC Pawns. And they're not NPCs, they're just in-game Pawns that are made by the developers. But we're playing online, so we could use other players. However, I think I'll just stick with it to keep the difficulty not too easy. I might just stick with two people, me and my pawn. And I think it's better to have your pawn out. I think it actually makes it a bit more like an adventure game. And I'm not sure exactly what kind of character I'm going to make. Probably a cool badass warrior chick with an old wizard, or a slick rogue and like some warlock or witch kind of character. As long as the two characters seem to complement each other, I'm okay with it. Now, I'm not sure if this is part of the game, but the reason, like, if you look at my character, he's holding up his shield in front of him. Is this like a setting or a thing I've done? So if I run, he'll put away his shield. Ah, okay. So when in his combat stance, he holds up the shield anyways. I'm not sure what good that does, and doing that seems to make me move slower. Liquid Vim. Now let's have a look at this item. I did pick this up earlier on. Sorry. That's See, the thing is, the menus are different. There's two menus. There's the inventory menu, and there's like your quest stuff menu. And they usually, in most games, would be in the same area, but not in this one. So I'm just getting used to that. Now this is the Liquid Vim. So you don't lose stamina, so this is the orange bar. So I assume that means you can run infinitely, or you can keep swinging, which is pretty OP actually. I'm putting this on my 2 hotkey. Since this is the tutorial area, I'm going to lose these hotkeys later because I won't have these items. I'll put this on the 3 hotkey, which is the Hearthbud Milk. That's like the general potion. Recovers health, recovers stamina both. And these are just herbs. This stops poison. Don't need that though. The tutorial has no poison, I don't believe. And these heal you. So I'm going to put this on 4 and this on 5. And then we're going to press the I. So that removes the inventory as well as escape. Now I'm going to do 2. Oh, that was the Liquid Vim. My mistake. I'll use the 3 Harspid Sauce. So I'm out of those, and as you can see, there's no item on the side of the screen. Because I just used all 3. Now I'm hoping this guy jumps down, and he's pretty cool to look at as well. This is the boss of this area. Ooh. Wouldn't like to meet him when I'm walking home from anywhere, I guess. So, fortunately, I still have my Liquid Vim. It looks like cutscene. I wish I could target. I can't. So you can press F, also I learned this, to climb. Oh, there is poison in this area as well. I can clearly see that's poison. I hope I don't get poisoned. Oh, it looks like you get poisoned in that area. Also, I forgot to summon the 2 pawns earlier on. So you press E. Oh, we're asleep. I forgot to summon 2 pawns earlier on. Remember that stone in the tutorial area? That's an extra pawn. Now, he's eating on me, but... unfortunately, I can't see because the camera angles. But it looks like I've escaped. If I'm not stuck in his body, hopefully I've escaped. There we go. Why must games do this to me? Why must they bug out in the tutorial areas? It looks so strange the way I move so slow, but it's... it's not like I'm dropping frames or anything. So I'm gonna go with, 4. Okay, so we've got... 4, which is our heal. Now, I'm gonna climb on this, and I'm gonna hit this attack. I'm gonna cut off this tail. Because that's the one that spits the poison. Ooh! I love those effects, they're crazy cool. Look at the blood coming out of it for a while. Oh, and it stays in the ground too. We don't do very much damage to this, but that done a lot more. Does the goat take more damage than the lion? Oh, it does. But I wonder, is it because the goat is weak to physical and the lion is weaker to magic, maybe? Or maybe the goat? Because these heads die one at a time, by the way. Like, you can kill the lion head and leave the goat alive, and the snake, and like, you can literally, like, it's either the goat or the lion. Like, the snake is kind of just its own thing on the end. Jeez. But because the goat uses magic, so I'm inclined to think that since it's taken much more physical damage than the lion, that it perhaps is, magic enemies are weak to physical, and physical enemies are weak to magic or something, I don't know. So he's still alive. So I'm gonna climb here, because if nothing else, we'd like to take out the goat head, and do some more damage. I hope this video's quality is better. I think we killed it. Oh, we did. I hope this video's quality is better than the Dark Souls one, because I didn't really want to mess around with my video quality in the middle of a Dark Souls series, because I'd already gotten like through the first few episodes. But the OBS is kind of awkward, because my computer's not super strong. It's not like strong enough to play, The Witcher 3 with the stream 2, but it is strong enough to play like like an MMO at max settings, or Dark Souls, or even Skyrim, or something like that, older games, comfortably, like super comfortably. Like, I could be listening to YouTube like in 3 different tabs, and then be streaming. No, then be playing the game, but then whenever I try to stream, which is just recording locally, not even... when I say stream, I mean record locally rather than, like, on Twitch or something. It seems that the game doesn't slow down at all. The game runs perfect, but the recording doesn't record perfectly. And the recording either records at lower frames with lag, or at super high quality, or at super low quality. So you can trade, like, quality for lag. Obviously, I chose to kind of go somewhere in the middle, but have less quality, because lag makes things unwatchable. There we go, 4. So as you can see, it's quite hard to die, but I assume that when you run out of healing things, it'll get much more difficult. And jumping out of the way does seem to work similar to dodging. It doesn't make you invulnerable, but hitboxes are slightly better than DS2. Much better, actually. If you hit something, they're damn well taking damage. Now, I haven't been like climbing on him because, well, there's not much damage I can do. Well, actually, I guess I could climb on his face. Just go crazy. But as you can see, this guy's taking barely any damage. I assume that he'd take a lot more magic damage, but we're a warrior because the tutorial makes us that way, and our friend is a warrior too. One of the pawns you can summon in the tutorial area actually buffs everyone's weapons with magic, which I guess is quite good. And there's also a mage that also just attacks straight away with like lightning, and that was super strong against this guy. So yeah, I'd recommend summoning those pawns, and it'll make your life easier. I wonder, does he take more damage in his face? I would assume he does, but he's taking plenty of damage here. which is his, like, arm. I love these camera angles, by the way. I guess, I can't really warp the camera out of this area either. I'm just, pressing, I'm spamming R1 and hoping that, he dies so I can escape the camera angle. There we go. He's dead. Oh, you drain stamina as you're climbed onto him as well. That's probably pretty evident, but, when you're on low stamina, you get, like, put into this, like, weakness hold thing, where you can't move or do anything. The goat body part doesn't, when the goat is dead at least, the goat body part doesn't actually take more damage either. I wonder, like, does the main body take barely any damage no matter what? And then the heads take, no damage depending on what type of damage you're doing. So, the lion takes nothing but magic and the goat takes nothing but physical. And there we go. There's no gestures either, so I can't fist bump.
Now choose, flee, or step forth. Take hold of what lies beyond. Claim mastery over the eternal ring.
Compared to Scholar, this game looks about the same, except the distant shots, like the distant areas, which aren't a skybox, look awful compared to Dark Souls, but the character models don't look like potatoes. Well, I've always kind of found game characters look like potatoes no matter what game they're in. Like, even the really good stuff, like games that really care about the graphics, they kind of look like potatoes. Obviously, different levels of good and bad potatoes, but still potatoes. But this obviously is what I'm saying is a much better potato than the Dark Souls potato. And I'm not talking about potatoes just because I'm Irish either. So this is a dragon. Grigori, I think his name is. Cutscenes look pretty damn good, but I have no idea what this dragon is doing or why we're talking to it or anything. We just know it exists. It's also kind of interesting because when I was creating the character, which I'll probably have to do now, I'm pretty sure I have to do it now. Alright. You can actually change the skin color, so you could make an orc. It's very awkward to navigate this menu, that's what I will say. So you press this. Okay, so it's super unresponsive. I have no idea how it works. So I'm trying to actually, no, that doesn't work. I think I have to press escape another time. Damn it. So it's spamming, it's like forcing you to do this. I guess we're gonna skip this and go for the moniker. I'm gonna pick a name that looks okay, because the name comes up like this anyways for other players, I believe. So, and it's not like in these games you actually see your name ever. It's not like the NPCs ever say your name. Zura. Now, that's the same name with a Z. I like it. I'm taking that. Now, I'm hoping this will allow me to... Damn it, to escape. Oh, we have to do it. So So I have to pick one of these. I'm picking a female anyways, so. So I think it was just forcing you to do that because of the fact that you were starting your first time. Name stays. And the backspace key, which wasn't working earlier on, works now. I think they're just forcing you to finish off the basic stuff like as you do it and not make changes till after. But also another thing is you can't change the way you look until like I think after the end of the game or something, or then any of you edit your character in any way. You can like change the hair or whatever later on, but never your character. So like if you just click the confirm button once too often, you'll have, you know, be forced into playing a character that you may not want. Now we're going to be pretty badass. So, yeah, this one. A test voice is O, so. I'm not sure. Wow. What are you, two years old? Jesus. Oh my god. It's okay. They sound like they have asthma. Also asthma. What about six? Those Japanese people. Making me no normal voices. So, there we go. Okay. Now, make more detailed edits is where you want to go. Now, before we go anywhere, there's color adjustment, and you can change the skin color. These are all locked, by the way. You have to unlock them with, like some currency in the game, which is silly. And but you can, one of them is, like, an orc color, and then there's, like, some interesting so if you accidentally pressed enter one more time, you'd have confirmed, and you can never change that. When I say you can never, you can, but not till, like, I think the post-game it's called. So, orange skin color. Can we get an orange skin color? A red one? Or black? No, I think we're gonna go with kind of like, that kind of color. Maybe, no. Yep. Don't worry. We're gonna get out of here first, and we're going to go with make more detailed edits. We're gonna go through preset faces, no. Hairstyle, yes. I like that. Not a fan of that. Just move back a bit. Jesus, there are you, germs. That's okay. We don't want something too gimpy looking, but we also don't want something too immersion breaking, I guess. What are those? Does anyone have those in their hair? These are some generally terrible choices. That's awful. Those Japanese people, right? no, I think we'll go with the ones we've seen near the start. This. They changed nothing, if anything. I'm sure one of them looks slightly better, but. Wait, one second. I hate the way it kicks you back to that menu as well whenever you just want to exit out of something. Zero details. Ah! What's this do? Makes your head larger? No. I think it was here. Was it here? It was here. I hope it was there. Okay. Oh, damn it. I kind of wish it would stop kicking me back here. To make any edit, it's ridiculous. So my first complaint of this game is its menus are awful. Now, eyes. Jesus. Damn. So we're at 20, so that's our standard. That's our go back to if we don't like one of them. But what about this? That's pretty damn thug. No, we're gonna go with this one. I'm gonna go with browse. Zero. Now this just allows you to change the color, but we're gonna go with black. I'm not gonna really get too stuck into small details. But we do want our character to look interesting at least. Nose, mouth, nose, no. I hate messing with noses. They're my bane in character creators. At least you can kind of see the... Make more detailed edits. Wow. Ears? No, we don't need to look at ears at all. The body, preset bodies, stature, height. We're gonna be tall as hell. No, we're not. We're actually gonna be that. I'm gonna be pure skinny. Weight, slim. I kinda like this more. Yep. Skin color we've already done. I wonder, is there another way back? What about escape? Oh my god, that works. So, backspace. Which, oh, well, I guess it says close and back here, so it's my own fault. But backspace should only be back a step. Escape should literally be to escape. Torso. I'm not messing around with that, and those all look gimpy anyways. No. I think I just accidentally... I need to stop pressing that button. Now it's my fault. We're going to go to 10. And then we're going to go to arms. And can we make those smaller? So we're on 6. So they get longer. They got fatter. Does this make it? Okay, that makes it slightly shorter, but it's not skinnier. Because the arms look too muscly, I think. Yeah, I guess that'll do. Eh? Oh, escape key. I think that really matters. I guess the middle. And I've done it again. We've already done this one, but there was the other one that we didn't do, build. No, that's Hulk, but we're not Hulk, so we're gonna go with... And we need to reduce the head size. I left that up, I think. Jeez. Wow. The larger ones actually look normal. No, never mind. Yep, the game is right. And every pervert that ever is gonna watch this is gonna be like, damn, why didn't you go huge? Face shape, I think it was. I'm putting way too much time into character creation. I usually don't. Get back there, spin around. I don't really know what looks normal. I guess that kind of looks normal. Or not. Does that look normal? I don't know. That looks sort of normal. Right. That's an our character is gonna be a rogue, I think. That's what I'm leaning towards. Zora the rogue. Oh wait, one more minute. We forgot one important thing. Scars. Now I'm gonna go all out here with that. But actually I think you can get cuts on the arms too as well. Oh, you can get a cut on the eye. Which is pretty damn interesting, because that would be the eye that, yeah. Okay, I like that, but I want to have a look to see if there's this, yeah. That doesn't really go to that eye, though. Okay, so this is us. And, wrinkles. Thankfully, there's not many wrinkles. And makeup. What makeup? Actually, that looks weird. That looks a lot better, actually. And color adjustment. Hair color. I kind of got used to this one. Actually, is there a redder color? A fuller kind of color? That is actually probably the better one. And eye will be blue. And escape. Are we okay with this character? Yeah. Well, I mean, character. Doesn't really matter, does it? Yes, I'm ready to play. I like the way that character creation took way longer than the actual tutorial did. And the tutorial took way too long than it should do because of the fact I didn't summon any friends to help me kill that ridiculous line. Our character looks so bad. We should have just went ridiculous and made our character look really, really silly. I don't get it. Is that our character's, oh, never mind. Oh, apparently it is, or...
it's the dragon!
Am I the only one that kind of wants the dragon to just kill my character right now and have it over with? That is so silly. Our character opened our eye that is completely closed with the scar. Immersion broken completely. It's pretty cool that it's actually raining when it's not raining, but it's like the water coming up from the dragon splash. I wonder, can you kill the dragon now? So this is, by the way, I'm not positive, the last enemy of the game, like the last main boss of the game. And yeah, you fight him now, but I don't think you can kill him. but I wonder, is it possible? It would take hours, of course, like we get the basic sword, with obviously very minimal stats and like level 1. Anyways, he will backhand you. Whoa, those iron angles, please don't do that. So he's... By the way, those dots are bars of health, so once you kill his bar of health, he'll just get another bar up until all of those dots are gone. I guess this allows... It kind of makes you see progress of your swings, so it doesn't look like it's taking hours to kill an enemy, or like one swing is doing your own damage. Oh, we stabbed him. How pro. We picked our eyebrows to be black. Why are they yellow? I want my money back. I definitely turned subtitles on as well. I'm so annoyed by those eyebrows. Damn. I guess you could say he's pretty heartless. But now he's full of heart. Damn those pixels. So that's the game over. We're dead. We can't finish. It was a pretty short game, but it was good. End credits roll. Oh no, they tricked us. I have no idea, like, if this character is relevant to us, or if they are relevant to us, why. Oh, the subtitles are definitely on though. But the yellow eyebrows are frustrating me because I picked black eyebrows, I know that. The default were brown as well, so it's not like it didn't save. And our eyebrows are black there, it looks like. No, they're yellow. What? It's odd because, like, the textures and everything, the meshes are pretty bad, but the character models are still okay. They're not bad. And the cutscenes are awful. Like, the fact my eyebrows change color in the cutscenes is so annoying. And also... No, they are. What the hell? We definitely picked black. I'll have to rewatch the video to see if I'm just gone crazy, which is entirely possible. Ooh, so we get to pick our basic class. I'm not gonna pretend I didn't already know that you did that here. I had to play through this part. And then you just press continue again. Now. Take water, we can't. But we can take this. And Mithridate, if I'm not mistaken, is the... Ooh, one sec. Blank scroll. Mithridate is the... Oh, what is it? It's the poison, purge poison body thing. Can I break these? I broke your pots. There's a rock there. He's gonna be my new pet. Ooh, cutscene.
You say it left a glowing scar?
Yes. The wound has closed, and it seems the worst has passed, but... Her heart... silent.
If you would face me.
You are sure of this?
Yes.
Ill magic, the work of some curse. The whole world's already gone mad for fear of this dragon. Won't no good come of this. I must go see to the others, Kina. Tell me if aught changes here.
All right.
So I wonder, is there any good reason to let these townsfolk live and not kill them? Our character is so thugging, but also so ridiculous. Yellow eyebrows. Yellow eyebrowed fool. Ceramic jug. Now, I don't want to pick up everything, because there's a weight limit, I believe. If we look at our... Yeah, see, there's 5.87 out of, I don't know, but it looks to be... about 40, maybe? 50? Your weight limit is derived from your character's height, weight, that kind of thing. A calculation, a formula out of those two things. But it also reduces your stamina, so you don't just pick a huge fat character that's super tall. So there's a thing in this game called stages, and stages are pretty much... I wish I could double jump. So stages are pretty much like different quests become available at different stages, but in different areas. So you play through this game, and oh wow, there's a chest there, pretty awesome. So you play through this game, and like in this area, there might be two quests. You do them, but if you haven't finished more of the main quest, no more quests will become available. But if you continue the main quest and don't come back to all the areas you visited to take the new quests, they'll sometimes never be available again. They are only available for a certain few stages. So kind of it gives the impression that the world is an alive one, where different characters move around and their stories happen whether or not you take place. You take part in them. However, you know, it kind of makes it hard to get, like, be a completionist in this game, because things do happen without you, and you can't be expected to come back at every different interval of the game to just check in and see if there's any new quests. Why? Because it would be awfully boring. It would be super boring, and you might just miss that one quest and never be able to do anything. Now, I'm not going to be doing all the quests. I'll be doing the main quest of this game. It's an RPG, so it has a lot of side quests, and if I was to do all of them, or even half of them, it would probably make for a boring watching experience, a boring playing experience. Well, I wouldn't say that, because I'd say the quests are okay. But also, I like the way I can platform off things. This is a big upside to the game. A boring watching experience at least, though, and it would take way too long. So yeah, I have no idea what I'm doing. I don't think the game's given me an objective yet. We're just going seeing what's happening. You know, we're chilling. I don't think we talked to the lady either, so this notice board gives us quests too. So kill 10 bandits, kill 10 goblins, kill 7 mice, and kill 7 rabbits. And it gives you the locations you need to do these in. The region for the mice is unknown, but I assume that mice are everywhere, like in every game. So we're gonna take all of these quests. They're just kill quests, and I'm certain. I'm pretty certain that they auto-complete. Like, once you finish them, you don't have to, see, I read all the, these things that come up on the screen, the hints and tips. I've read all of those. I'm only skipping them now, because there's no point. Pablos. He's a Mexican immigrant, so when Trump builds the wall, he's going to kick Pablos out. So Bitter Black Isle is a DLC area, so we're not going to be taking those out, because we do have the weight thing to worry about. This weighs pretty much nothing, 0.1 unit, but it's for also that DLC, I believe. I think these are, yeah, DLC items. Now, we do have some items. I think these are DLC items that were given, like, as one of those 2 euro packs, and you get, like, things. But since it's the PC port, it has all of the DLC animes. I didn't buy any of this stuff. And you equip your pawn with your own gear, so you need to make sure you've items for that. So this is our bank, so I'm going to actually take out this item here, Robe of Enlightenment, and this item here, the Wavering Cloth, because these are... Well, this is a mage item, and our pawn will be a mage. And I believe this is the thief item. They're about the same in stats. So there's only two stats, defense and magic defense, and then there's like an element that might be resistant to, but not all items have this, and maybe items of two or three. Dark defense or ice defense? I don't know if it matters, and I don't know if that's ice. That could be lightning, I'm not sure, but it looks to be kind of a lighter color. The elements are down here, by the way, near the defenses. And these are the classes it's for. So you've these basic classes, we got to pick one of these three, and then like these advanced classes get unlocked later, I think. I'll probably go with this though, because we're a rogue and it fits us, and we can use this too, so we can take that. And there's rings. Dagger ring, so I'll take this, and that's staff bearer, so I'll take that too. Now we're gonna escape out of there, and never mind. We can change our equipment there, but we can change that elsewhere as well. So we're gonna open this door. Complete your son. Oh, those are the notice board quests. They'll keep popping up until they've all popped up, so not much you can do about that. So equip that. Wavering Cloth. So that looks pretty good. I think these DLC items are like good for the early game, so I'm not gonna say no. Dagger String, Biting Wind, Cutting Ring Wind get improved. They seem to be starter spells, I guess. I think it improves them, by the way, because it says Biting Wind, Cutting Wind. Let's have a look at our attacks. We have Scarlet Kisses and Threefold Arrow. And this is our bow mode. So Q obviously toggles bow mode. So let me. Okay, so we can aim with our bow by clicking the right mouse button, but only if we're in bow mode, because otherwise you do this. So this seems to be a merchant. And this area also seems to be a merchant's. Some interesting loot there. I don't know if you get counted as stealing if you take from other people's homes. I'm not sure at all. But since nobody's looking, what's the harm? I think we need... I don't know how you stop holding the daggers, but I think running puts them away anyways. Yeah. There's probably an easier way to do it, but running's not too difficult anyways. We're gonna go here, and we're going to open, and we're going to see about buying and selling some things. Oh, we can sell from item storage. I assume this is only available if you're in a town that would also be able to bank your items. So we're going to sell the pet rock. 4 gold, we have 2,000, so that's just a drop in the water. Drop in the ocean. Clean papyrus gold, ready for the quill. A combinable, oh, that's a crafting material, I'd assume. We can sell these since we can't use them. I'm only abusing that now. Now we won't ever be making a warrior character, but just in case, we'll keep it. Vagamond armor? We won't need that, but I'll keep it just in case. Oh, I never took one of these out. Oh, so these are all generic. This fetches 312,000 gold, so I'm gonna sell that no matter what, because, well, there's two other ones and they're generic, right? Yeah. Okay, so we sell those items, and now we can hopefully go back and buy from her. No materials. Materials I'd just buy all of, just in case. We have a lantern. We'll buy a pickaxe for mining, I guess. Does it mine? Yeah, tool employed to mine ore. Flask of oil. These, throw them. Do these light the lantern also? It doesn't say it does. flask filled with fuel. Throw in an adversary, dice them and all. I'm gonna buy two because they're cheap, but I don't. They'll be pretty useless if you don't, you know, use oil. Sorry, if you don't, if they don't fuel lanterns, because we won't be using random items like that. Now, poison arrows are great in Dark Souls, but I don't know if they'll be any good in this game. Because even though they don't weigh much, like, that'll add up. As you can see on the bar up here, it does add up, and that's only 5 arrows. We'll leave those for now. Oil arrow. So, apparently oil gives a debilitation or a condition or something to the enemies, so we'll look into that later. Now, these are upgrades for weapons. Now, these are the throat cutters, so they actually nearly double that. No. They boost damage by just a bit over 50, which is seems to be good because we've only got 77 base damage right now. We could also buy a bow and a staff for our friend that once we get him. Like, this looks like the best staff out of those two. I can't see the stats here because probably I'm not in the right class, but this one costs more and it's called Ironclad, which sounds better than the wooden. So we'll just use our little bit of logic there, and then we'll get the short bow, which is, seems about relevant for us. I think I'll leave armor for now. We can come back and buy it later. Check out. Change our equipment. Yeah, we'll change our equipment right now. Sorry about that noise. Equip. And we're going to equip that. And that's all we need to do. Now we can back off. We can, you know, move over here. And we should be able to leave the town now. And I think with that, we'll call this episode an end. Oh, there's a cutscene. Oh, these are the pawns, by the way. This thing that's happening is when you summon a pawn. It happened in the tutorial area. First time. Look at that cool looking dude. Nice mustache there. Nice hair. Oh wow, he's giving me the you know the Yo sign. Because we're part of the Yo clan. That's a pretty damn cool scar actually.
That man you are speaking with, he's of the Pawn Legion. They come from some unknown place, just appear without a warning. Strange lot.
Yeah, they're pretty weird.
Not human, quite. They look the part, sure enough, but they lack the will, the spark, what drives.
That guy with the mustache definitely it does not look human.
They have no capacity to feel nor act alone, so they live as cell sorts. Myrmidons, they're
Myrmidon. That's a rank in the arena in Elder Scrolls Oblivion. You can become a Myrmidon. And I had to Google what Myrmidon meant, because I remember when I was first playing the game, it made no sense to me. I never heard of it.
Encampment west of the village, where men gather to face the dragon. I'd wager a fair number of his kind will be there as well.
This guy's huge muscles as well. Like, this guy's, I'd say, like, winning an arm wrestling competition.
Why don't you take him? Might be you learn aught of why he came to you in the first place.
Before leaving, visit the store to make sure you've ample supplies.
Okay, thank you very much for watching, guys. That was Dragon's Dogma, Dark Arisen, the first part of this series, and we got to the tutorial, we created a character that took way too long. Unfortunately, we have yellow eyebrows, even though we selected black ones. Jesus game, that's a bug, man. And yeah, so you got started, we met the first pawn that we're going to meet. This isn't our pawn, but hopefully we can get a new one soon. So yeah, thanks for watching, and peace out.